What's up guys, it's Brad from Lead Architect here. In this video, I'll be going through the fifth of the new city shot renders that we used in our CityBuilder 3D asset-based add-on trailer for Blender. These new shots that we added to the trailer were all created with the new Soviet assets that we've added to CityBuilder, modeled and textured by Hubert Knoblau. These video breakdowns should show how you can create some pretty awesome city flyover shots fairly quickly inside of Blender. Anyways guys, let's get started. Here we are inside of Blender, and this is our fifth project file here. As you can see on the right side, we just have our camera view here, and on the left side is our general scene setup. On the left side, you can see that we have a variety of our new Soviet assets kind of just placed in strategic places on our ground plane here. We've used a few of the medium-sized assets as well as all of the large assets as well to create this kind of city square with some buildings inside of it here, and to create kind of a cinematic overhead shot. And as you can see here, when we play through the timeline on the right side, you can see kind of what we've done to the camera. We've just animated it rotating around on the z-axis, kind of centered on the city square here. This circular asset in particular is super cool because you can combine it together to create kind of a circular square look, and you can use it to kind of create some walls and barriers in your scene in addition to the other Soviet assets. And definitely a pretty cool one to play around with for your scene setups. Anyways, we've just rotated this camera on the z-axis, and as you can see here, in addition to the rotation of the camera, it's also pushing in on the z-axis as well to create kind of a tracking in effect as well, which I thought created kind of an interesting shot for this specific set of assets here. Lighting our scene, we have two suns side lighting our buildings. As you can see here, if we go to the lighting tab, we've increased the strength of the suns to 2.5, and then we've warmed up the color to create a yellow sunlight feel and add some shape and specularity to the assets themselves. Under the world properties, we've also added a basic sky to the scene, and we've increased the strength of the sky as well to create the ambient lighting within our world. And we've also used two different sky textures and pictures of cities on emission planes to kind of create specularity and reflections on our city assets as if they were in the real world. And again, you can also use an HDRI for this purpose, but sometimes it's nice to use emission planes with real textures so that you can kind of place them exactly where you want them to create some more realistic lighting sources and environments for your city assets. And essentially that's our scene setup here. Like a lot of our other shots in the trailer for our ground plane, in addition to recreating the ground of our scene as an asphalt material, we've also created a particle system with 3200 particles distributing three of our other city assets here on the particle system across the base layer of the city. So again, what we're doing here is we're just placing the bigger assets more specifically, and then when we turn on the particle settings that distribute the smaller assets, as you can see, it kind of fills in the gaps and creates that larger city feel for the final result. Just like a lot of the other shots we created in our trailer, we've chosen to emit both a combined beauty pass as well as a mist pass from Blender for our compositing process. And again, to export any pass that you want from Blender to any compositor of your choice, you would just check the data that you want exported, and then under the compositing tab here, you would just export your beauty pass to your composite, and then whatever other passes you want, in our case the mist pass, we've exported to another folder of our choice. We've rendered out this specific shot at 40 samples, 1080p resolution, again using our OpenEXR file format with an alpha channel for pretty good detail and dynamic range. Alright guys, here we are inside of After Effects, and this is our final composite here. And as you can see here, we've added a variety of mist and atmospheres as well as our mist pass to add that level of depth and create a little bit more of an interesting composite. Anyways, let's go through the composite layer by layer. Alright, so the first pass that we added was of course our basic beauty pass. After adding our beauty pass, we've added the mist pass on top of it, and that's just adding that procedural mist that gets thicker the further away certain objects are away from the camera. After adding that mist pass, then we've just added a whole bunch of live action atmospheres to blend our environment into the real world a little bit better. And to place these atmospheres in our scene, what we've done is we've actually 3D tracked our beauty pass using the After Effects camera tracker. And then what we've done is we've used that tracking data to place these atmospheres in different parts of our scene so that as the camera rotates, they rotate with it more naturally. And then if I wanted to add movement to certain parts of the atmosphere, I could do that separately, but the atmosphere would already contain the movement of the 3D camera since it had been tracked inside of After Effects. So any further animation would just be added to it and could be done much more seamlessly for our scene. And a lot of the time when your 3D camera is just panning from right to left or tilting up and down, you can get away with not actually tracking your atmospheres that are going by your camera in the foreground, but since this specific shot was a rotational movement, it helped a lot to track the shot before we actually added the layers of atmosphere, as it would be difficult to animate those atmospheres rotating in the exact fashion of our 3D shot. So that's what we've done here. Finally, for the final layer, we've just added an adjustment layer with some basic color correction on it to increase the contrast. And then again, in our color correction, we've just added a Fujifilm 250D look to the final shot. And then on top of everything, we've just added that basic letterbox for a widescreen look in this final result. Anyways, guys, that's it for this video. I hope it was helpful. As always, feel free to leave any comments if you have any questions or suggestions in the comment section below. Let us know what kind of videos or breakdowns you'd like to see next. And if you like this content, be sure to subscribe and hit that bell notification. I'll see you next time.